Hi, this is Minan from the Value Investing How To channel. So today we're gonna talk about this thing called the property valuation. Okay, while you watch this video, do exercise independent thinking. Recently, one of my REITs sold away two buildings. But we're gonna just use one of the building as an example. In 2012, 2013, 2014, 2015, initially the building was bought for $1 billion. Okay, then at the point of time when you wanted to purchase this building, right, you definitely have to take on, most likely you have to take on borrowings to fund this purchase, right? So there will be this interest expense being incurred, right? So then the next year, maybe it was a bad year, it went down to 740 million. Then it went down maybe over at the same stage at 750 million. Still not 2013, 2014, there's still the interest expense, because due to the borrowings here also, right? So all these are outflows from the REIT structure itself. And at 2015, it sold away this building for a 1.12 billion. Wow. So the gap here is often what we see as a valuation loss, right? Valuation loss. Here was a tiny valuation gain, okay, because it increased from 740 to 750 million valuation gain. And from here to here is a huge increase. So did our REIT manager really do well? From here to here, yes, it did well. Often what I'll do to double check is finding out the year that they purchased this building, and it was at 2012, and I measure the performance from here to here, because that will show me the true performance of the REIT manager despite all the valuation losses and gains. Why? Because in 2015, don't forget, you still have the interest expense, right? So the gain, even though there's a magnificent gain here, but between the year that they purchased until the year that they let go of the building, it was only 200 million that they have earned. We have to take account into this interest expense they all has to go up, because they are really cash flowing up from the REIT structure. So the next round that you look at your REIT portfolio, especially when they buy or sell a building, just take note of this thing called the property valuation. Thank you for watching this video, and stay tuned and see you soon.